So I went through all our data sets, and I found one person with the highest giver score in his company and the lowest revenue. And I asked him, how do you explain this? Why do you suck at your job? I didn't mess with that one. But what's the cost of generosity in sales? And he said, well, if I could be totally candid with you, I just care so deeply about my customers that I would never sell them one of our crappy products. This is sad news for givers. How many of you believe that you're more of a giver than a tinker or a magic? Okay, it would have been more before we talked about this evidence. But this unfortunately happens to givers all the time. An example that I found to be really fascinating is Kat Cole. Kat was the first person in her family to make it to college after being raised by a single mother who had to work three jobs just to be able to create a food budget of $10 a week. And Kat has to carry two jobs of her own all through high school. She serves in a restaurant, she sells clothes at a mall. And Kat's the kind of giver who always likes to help and never asks for anything in return. So one day in her restaurant, the cook doesn't show up. And Kat is the one to race back in the kitchen and start cooking. Another day, manager quits, and Kat takes it upon herself to organize the schedule so everyone can maintain their desired shift, and the restaurant keeps smooth operations. And nobody really notices that this is happening. Kat doesn't get any credit or recognition for it. And this is the kind of situation that drives all of us crazy. Like, we have a woman doing the lion's share of the helping and giving and getting nothing in return. And if the story ended there, it would be a little bit depressing. But then it takes a surprising twist and gets much worse. Because Kat is so dedicated to helping other people in a restaurant that she ends up failing all of her classes and having to drop out of college. And that's what happens to a lot of givers. They don't secure their oxygen masks before helping others. And this is more true for women than men. Women feel a tremendous sense of responsibility to help other people. They tend to do more of the giving than men do, and they're at greater risk for burnout because of it. Which led me to wonder, if givers are the worst performers, who are the best performers? Go back to the engineer's productivity, the medical student's grades, the salespeople's revenue. Who do you think comes out on top? Let's get another vote. How many think the best performers typically are the takers? Raise your hands. How many for the matchers?